Hello viewers, in this video I will show you the demo of different types of grafting and I will reveal the secret behind successful grafting. The one which you are seeing now is cleft grafting, which I made on hibiscus plant. Here the rootstock is red color variety and the scion is white colored variety, and I'll tell you what is rootstock and scion in this video. Here the cambium layer is well regenerated, and don't worry, I will tell you about cambium layer in this video. See how the scion is get fixed with the rootstock with the help of cambium layer. The upper part of the graft is known as scion, and the lower part which contain roots is called rootstock. To be a graft successful, the scion and rootstock must be related species. Before grafting any plants, you must sterilize your grafting tools using alcohol sterilizers. The main secret behind successful grafting is matching the cambium layers. Cambium is a very thin layer between the bark and the inner stem. The marking which I am making now is the cambium layer. While uniting both the scion and rootstock of a graft, this cambium layer should be matched. Observe how I am matching the cambium layers in both the scion and rootstock. If the scion and rootstock are in same width, this cambium layer will be easily matched. After uniting the scion and rootstock, it must be tied tightly with rope or using polythene strips. First demo I am showing is splice grafting. While doing splice grafting, give a slanting cut to the rootstock and also the same slanting cut to the scion. The length of the slanting cuts in both the scion and rootstock must be same. After giving two flat cuts on both the scion and rootstock, unite them. Make sure the cambium is matched. Then tie the grafted area tightly with rope. And the second demo which I am showing now is whip and tongue grafting. The first thing you have to do is give a flat cut on the scion. After making a flat cut, make a tongue starting at the 3/4 of the flat cut. Look where I am ending the knife. Now the tongue is made. Give same flat cut on the root stock. Make sure the flat cut of both the root stock and scion are in same length. Make the tongue similar to the tongue which I made on the scion. Start the tongue at 3/4 of the flat cut. Now fix both the scion and rootstock. Now you can see Z-like appearance on grafted portion. And the third one is cleft grafting. This one is also called wedge grafting.
Give flat cuts on both the sides of the scion.
The flat cuts on both the sides of the scion should be in same length. After making the flat cuts, make a cleft on the rootstock.
Look how I am making the cleft. The cleft length should be similar to the length of the flat cut.
Now insert the scion into the rootstock. See, the cleft appears like a V. And the last one I'm showing is veneer grafting. That is side veneer grafting.
Make a cut like this on the rootstock. Make a similar cut on the scion. Now match the rootstock and scion with matching cambium layer. After matching the cambium layers, tie the grafted area using polythene strips.
I hope you understand how to make different types of grafting on plants.
Try making these crafts by yourself in your home. For more information about grafting, see the video description. And for more updates like this, subscribe to my channel. And finally, thanks for watching.